Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough! I hit this block and I hit a recording failure, but I'm glad I noticed that before I started going down, because... yeah, I don't want to redo this stuff from the start. I've come too far! Far too far! So, yeah, I think I'm gonna switch out to, Vivian here, and... let's get it started. Whatever happens during these last 10 floors, I love you all. Actually, I should have Goombella out because I see this is a new enemy here. Yo! I think what I'm going to do is the tattle and run strategy. I'm not going to be able to do it on floor 100 though, and you'll see why once I reach there, but yeah. Oh wow, we actually got two different new enemies here. The first, maybe it doesn't matter which one I tattle first, I guess. Yep.
That's an elite wizard! That is the top of the heap for half-machine organisms! Max HP is 12, attack is 8, and defense is 5! You can probably guess this, but use various magic moves in battle, and if it's alone, it'll create illusions of itself. It has no real weakness. So just use whatever you've got to beat it, okay? Let's go, Mario!
Yes, let's go! Run! please... okay. I was hoping that I wouldn't fail on the... on the runaway there. Okay. And... bloop. Oh! Well, that worked. As long as they don't first strike me, that's what makes me happy. Alright, now let's swap out, because I gotta do the poison puffs, because another new enemy right here, right off the bat. Here we go.
That's a poison puff! Basically just a puff of poisonous air. Match HP is 15, attack is 8, and defense is 0. Its poison gas attack is 10! These things can charge you, but they also save up toxins and poison you with them, scum. Plus, you can't touch them when they're saving up toxins and you'll get hurt. Lame!
If you don't realize it, these two versions of the enemies we've seen before are the hardest versions of the enemies. They are the strongest versions in the entire game, and they're found deep within the pits of 100 trials. So yeah, these 10 floors here, these are gonna be the hardest 10 floors in the game. Alright, now I should probably get myself set up with the Yoster. And... yo! There we go. Maybe I should have done a Super Hammer, but meh. Well, Ultra Hammer, but I don't really think it would matter all that much. I don't like that it's got a stopwatch. That could be a big, big problem. But anyway, let's try and get rid of it before it uses a stopwatch. Okay? Okay. So let's concentrate, and concentrate harder than we've ever concentrated before. Put all your focus into every single one of your moves and defenses, because this is a place that you do not want to lose at when you've gotten this far. Alright. Gulp. Yeah. And there we go. Takes care of the elite wizard. And now we've got an attack power up, but big whoop. Because it's just going to burn its turn. And I'll be able to wipe it out this turn. Maybe I'll switch out... no, wait, because he's going to use the life shroom again. I'll just normal jump on this one. Yeah, sweet. And now I'll gulp. Nom 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 nom. Yeah. Because the other one's too high up, I guess. Okay. That's not... I don't think I can jump on that. Should I switch to Vivian and, yeah, I think I'm gonna use Veil. There we go. A, B, A, B. Always think your button presses before you actually do the button presses. Just to make sure you'll get those button presses. Yeah, ha-ha! And normal jump. See, when they have that aura around them, when they're powering up for something, they're not like their usual selves, where you can just attack them with anything as long as you are within range of them, so yeah. There we go. One down, nine to go. Well, I got two tattles that I wanted to get so far. So, yeah. Okay, oh god, oh god, oh god, it's gonna attack immediately! Who should I have out? Oh. Everyone's getting a little low on HP. How about Flurry? Hold on. Wait for it. Wait for it. Yeah! Those first strikes matter so much. Oh god. I didn't think it was going to appear here. That's a Bob Oak. The most powerful version of the large Bob-ombs. So, I gotta set myself up properly. Running from battle won't change the types of enemies that appear in battle, which is why I do this. But it does allow me to set up for more... Ooh! It does allow me to set up for a better outcome. Okay, so Tattle, Bob-Ulk, and...
That's a Bob-Ulk! That's easily the biggest Bob-omb I've ever seen! XP is 10, attack is 4, and defense is 2. One attack, but once its fuse is lit, it'll explode after a while. So the problem is how to beat it before it goes off. I mean, its bomb attacks has a power of 16! That's no joke. Seriously, watch out for that. Just go all out to beat it, pull out all the stops, or you could just set it off early with fire explosions. Your call.
Run! Okay, there's another tattle on my tattle log. Okay, let's try and get our coinages back in case I can... Oh wait, actually I won't be able to buy stuff because I'm too far away from any sort of floor that one would appear at. But okay, I'm gonna... I guess use Flurry. Yeah, she's probably one of the best defensive partners in the entire game. Come on, get over... Yeah, yeah, alright. Now... Let's see what we can do!
Woo!
I think I'm probably just gonna end up starting off with a Earth Tremor here, just to maximize the damage output and see what we can do. And see where this gets me, because I most certainly want to take out that Bobble, because what it likes to do is it likes to raise its stats after lighting its fuse, and one of those stats that it raises is its defense. And then it raises its attack power. So once it raises its defense, it becomes even harder to dish off damage onto. And you don't want to get hit by something that does 16 points of damage. Okay, let's body slam the Bob-Ulk. And this should work. Lovely.
Woo!
There we go. Now. Oh, you hit the partner. I was expecting you to hit Mario. You gotta watch the swoop a little better. Okay, we're good. No one's powering up. How would I try a multi-bounce right across the top here? Yeah! They don't have very much defense points. In fact, I don't think they have any defense points, if I recall. Alright. Thought he slammed one with more HP. There we go. And now... This one should have 3 HP left by the time. Uh oh. That's a problem. Excuse me. I've been talking too much today. Maybe I should swap for Vivian again, just to dodge that. Okay! I put all my concentration into the buttons there, so I pause for that little second in my commentary. I don't want to make any unnecessary mistakes. Well, technically, any mistake is unnecessary, but what I mean is too many mistakes, or too far into this. Nice. All right, what should I go for? Maybe another boost to the flower points. They have been serving me well around this place. Yeah! Alright.
Woohoo!
I am so nervous right now. I mean, it's only been 2 floors on these last 10, and... wow. Ah, Bobulk. Alright. I wonder... let's try Bobbery. And... I bet it's gonna be like 4 of them. Just... yep, 4 of them! It always seems to be like there's one of these... 4 battle... I mean, 4 Ba-Bomb battles here. Alright, I'm gonna do this. Sort of like chain attack him like so, and then Ba-Bomb Bast. Yeah, that was easy. Woo! I'm only kind of doing that because I just got my stats. Oh, right. Oh, I forgot about that effect. Ah! By the way, their explosions are unblockable. Yeah. Mucus, clear up. I got a fire flower. That might be useful in some circumstances. Obviously don't want to use them on the Bobulk. Just blow them all up! Alright, oh, we can skip some floors! I gotta check my notes here to make sure I'm not gonna skip something that I want to get. The Swampire is the only thing that I need left. And that apparently shows up on floor 94 and 98, but we are on 94 right now, so it's not going to appear on this floor. I got the Poison Puff, Bobulk, Elite Wizard, and then there's one more thing. But let's see if I can skip, I mean, how many floors I can skip. Should probably skip 2 levels. Yes. Alright. So, I got away with a little bit extra here. Thanks to our fuzzy friend. Now, I am... actually... yep! Oh, poopers. I was gonna say, actually, I'll try and do as much damage as I can to these bad boys before they start poisoning up on and attacking everything, but... Should I use a Sweet Feast? I haven't used one of those in a while. I think that might be a good idea here, because I can recover star points as I go. Or star power as I go. Oh, whoa, oh shoot. It's holding a little bit too long there. Just gave me that... I mean, it had that one extra star. It was just strayed right after the Poison Mushroom. Alright, and... not bad. Could have been better, but not bad. Now what I'm gonna do is... run! Gotta pick... oh, shoot! Gotta pick your battles wisely. Oh! Oh, yeah! Okay, I'm gonna keep super guarding. Oh my god! Can I get 4 in a row? Can I get... oh, I got 4 in a row! I'm kind of glad I wasn't able to run now. Alright, so now I guess the battle is as it would be under normal circumstances, because I would start out by setting up with this and then exploding everything anyway, so, and that's going to do more than 14 damage. At least it should do more than 14 damage. Hopefully I'll be able to do more than 14. Just keep focusing on those nodes. Good. Feel the power of my rolling paper! And... oh, no, I wanna go... Bob-omb Bast. Meow, oh, so much power! Boom! Clear. Well, it's not more than 14, it's exactly... but yeah, whatever. We're good. Yeah! Maybe I'm gonna get another level up by the time I finish this place, because there is a possibility of a certain notorious golden sparkly thing appearing that gives a lot of experience points. Oh, you know what I'm talking about. Anyway. Let's hope that Swampire appears somewhere. Okay, let's not attack with Pottery this time, because I just blew up everything. Okay, turn around. You're really slow. You know, I made them do their attacks, and I didn't want them to do their attacks. There it is! One appeared! It's Amazing Daisy! Oh, God! Yeah, you can actually find them in groups of up to two, but they're always with other sorts of enemies. Boy, I don't have my art attack here. Should I be appealing and running and then getting my art attack ready? Maybe. I'm gonna go for that because the Bob ults don't really attack for a while. The only thing that I'm worried about is getting knocked out by that Amazing Daisy. Alright, so run away, go. Should be good. I can see the way it was bouncing. Okay, so now that I know there's an Amazing Daisy in with that group, I can plan sort of accordingly. Alright, I'm just gonna... that's not gonna be enough time. Do it here. There we go. Yeah, I was a little bit too close on that last hammer that I was gonna charge up there. Woo! Okay, now we're gonna do the appeal and run thing again. I think this should work. It'll kind of mess with my audience numbers, but... well... this is an Amazing Daisy we're talking about here. One of the most dangerous critters in the entire game. In fact, it has the highest attack power of anything in the game. So yeah. I wonder if I should even have Bobbery... I mean, not Bobbery out. Coops out and switch it out for Bobbery because he has over 20 HP. And, you know, he'll be able to survive said attack of the Amazing Daisy. So let's just keep charging up the star until we get art attack, I guess. Okay, it looks like we got it. So let's do it. Remember with the Amazing Daisy strategy, just circle around the Amazing Daisy and only around the Amazing Daisy at first. Because if you do not want this thing to attack, it can make you fall asleep, it does 20 points of damage, it's so cute, but it's so nasty. Okay, that's good. And now... oh shoot. I didn't really think that one out, did I? Because I can't use... yeah, oh, poopers. Well, I could blow up the Bob Ulks. I mean, it's not ideal, but they're only going to do 12 points of damage. Yeah, it's far, far less than the Amazing Daisy. Oh, caught off guard again. I was itching my nose when that happened. Look at those experience points! And that's the power of Amazing Daisy. I wonder if that's the reason why they put him down here, because you're able to get level ups just before the last floor and stuff like that. Flower points one more time. Woo. Oh yeah. Superstar! And now the stage gets even bigger! Yeah, the stage we've been playing on at level 30, I think it is. Yeah, I think I'm at level 30. Hold on. Oh shoot, I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to collect the stuff. But yeah, I think I'm at level 30 in my character. Yes, level 30. That's what happens when you get to level 30, is you get the biggest stage unlocked. And now I've got another critter to tattle here. So this is the most powerful version of our baddie friends. Yeah, it's a Swampire, and it is pretty nasty. You'll see why in a minute when I do the tattle. Oh my god! There's more Amazing Daisy! Oh my! I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Alright, so what I'm gonna do here is tattle a Swampire, and I'm gonna have to run. By the way, that Elite Wizard there has a Ultra Shroom. That's a little scary.
That's a vampire. It's a feared health sucker that hides in the darkness. Max HP is 20, attack is 6, and defense is 0. It sucks health from its prey to add to its own HP, and that totally grosses me out like you wouldn't believe. If you let it feast on you, its HP will get really high. Focus your attacks on it.
But for now, I'm gonna... Wait, actually, no, I don't have to run. Oh, I think this is the last floor that Amazy Daisies can appear on, so maybe it would be safe to just supernova everything out of here? Because I really don't like this enemy combination here. I know it burns so many star points, but yeah. Oh wait, actually, oh shoot, I gave the Amazy Daisies an opportunity to attack, actually. Oh, because I didn't run from battle, I'm stupid. They could wipe out Goombella. Not Mario, though. I hope they just run, actually, now that I think about it. Now that I'm all worried about it. Yeah! There we go. Gone. Gone. Okay, good. I will take that as a victory. Woo. Yeah, I should have just ran from there and maybe tried to get the experience points, but they got scared once he lost enough HP. Alright, so we're on floor... well, level 98. I always say floor instead of level for some reason. Moving on. Final floor. Before big 100. Alright. Here we go. Just do that. And... ah! Good. Very good, in fact. No more things to tattle in this place, by the way, except for what's on the next floor. Okay. I'm going to Earth Tremor. Because I'm not really going to be using star points for what's on floor 100 for the strategy that I'm going to be using. In fact, I'm going to show you what badge setup I'm going to be using for it. There we go. Okay, focus on the nodes. Oh, shoot! No! Still not bad. I can still Bob-omb-bast. And wipe them out. Yeah. Oh, no, wait, that's right, yeah. Poopers. That's nice. It's gonna use a shooting star, isn't it? Yep, I thought so. I can't block this. Yeah, 6. Okay, what's it gonna do? It's gonna power up. That one's gonna power up. That's actually good, because I'll be able to use another Bob-omb-bast here. And finish everyone off. Yeah! Beautiful! And I got some pretty nice stats going on here too, so... okay. I got the shooting star, that's nice. Alright, now, what I'm gonna do here is check out my badges and see what I don't need and what I would like to have. Probably another charge partner badge, because you know my boss strategy for charging up and then doing the... a multi-bonk thing. I know some people don't like that, and critique me all you want, but I've come a long way to get here, and I'm not going to risk losing. Although I still could lose, but I'm not going to take any chances here. Okay. Got everything here. I think this is what I'm going to use. These will prevent status. These will allow me to recover star stuff if I would like to. I got the power bounce, which is going to combine with the charge. I'm also going to use Goombella. So I gotta, oops, gotta switch over to her. And what's her HP? I forgot. It's 10. Yeah, I should probably use a Whack-a-Bump outside of battle here. This will also recover flower points that I used in the last battle here. There we go. And now, get ready for the fight of your life. Here we are. The bottom. The last floor. They were hinting that there was another of these dragons in this place. Meet Bone Tail! And some people consider this guy the hardest boss in the game, but I personally disagree with that. But anyway, I'm gonna do the tattle right off the bat here and see what we can do.
That's Bonetail. He's the oldest brother of Hooktail. So old, he's just bones. In fact, wow. Now that's old. His body's max HP is 200, his attack is 8, and his defense is 2. He has various breaths that might confuse us or put us to sleep. When his HP gets low, he'll recover. Or animate, as the case may be. He's probably stronger than the last boss. Seriously, let's do this right.
It's not really that difficult of a boss, in all honesty. It's just a matter of planning things out. Look, you gotta assume that you're gonna take 10 points of damage each turn, and then you've pretty much got this fight won. It's really as simple as that. But anyway, what I'm gonna do here is... Probably... tactics, and charge. Yeah! Okay, and he's gonna do some breath attack. Those breath attacks have different attributes. I think that white one there would have froze Mario if not for the one of those smiley face, you know, badges that prevent... I can't think of their names right now. That prevents status ailments, and yeah. Alright, let's charge up. I think so, yep. By the way, having the charges stacked uses up more flower points, but you'll be able to charge faster. Look at that. pain. I believe that chomp can also do poison damage. I mean, you can also poison whatever he chomps, so yeah. Alright, keep charging. You know the drill. Now I'm gonna do the power bounce soon enough. Charge. Bloop. And I'm gonna do a breath attack. Aw, a little bit off on my timing there, but whatever. Alright, let's do the power bounce. I think I'll do it on his Tootsie, actually. Not bad. And, oops. Attack. Multi-bonk. Yeah, I'll just do the multi-bonk now. That's pretty good. Took out a quarter of its HP. And he's gonna do a stomp. Oh, got lucky. Very nice. Alright, let's keep the whole charge strategy going on here. Yeah. Some people didn't like that I used this, but get to the 100th floor of the Pit of 100 Trials and you'll be using whatever you can. Okay. Charge. Unless you've got some sort of, like, special, challenge, like a personal challenge that you're going for here. Oh, we got a rock. Dang audience member. Yeah, shoo, shoo. You don't belong here. Charge. Woo. And one more charge for Goombella. Then I'll probably start doing the recovery stuff. Oh, it actually froze Mario. That sucks. But the charge is still in effect, so... Yeah. I wonder if I should do... a little bit of Ultra Shrooming here, because I've got so many items. And I don't want to use... I don't want Goombella to use the 1-Up Mushroom. That's poison. I mean, that color is poison. Alright, now... I think I'll do another charge. It's kind of risky to do so many charges in a row, in a way, because you might be doing charges for nothing, in a way, so to speak, maybe. And Mario's gonna be unfrozen. There we go. Takes one damage from being unfrozen. It's kind of weird. I always thought that was weird, because, like, you think you get healed from, you know, the ice, but you end up taking damage from the crack of the ice or something like that. I don't know. Alright, multi-bonk on the Tootsie. Oh man. Oh. Hey, he recovers. Whatever. I'm doing so much damage. It's like, okay, so he does that. It's not really that. Not too worrisome if he does that. Yeah. Charge. I think he only starts healing when he gets down to like half HP or something like that. Oh yeah, finally guarded it properly. Alright. How much attack power does Mario have, anyway? I wasn't really paying much attention to how many charges I had. Wow. Oh, shoot! No. That's why it's kind of risky to charge so many times in a row, because you waste a lot of charging and you might not be able to get as much as you're planning. Okay. And a stomp attack on who? Mario. Just like a little nail on the head. Alright. Charge! Whoop! And it's at 98 HP. It's gonna go down pretty quick. And there we go. And oh, must have healed itself again, but whatever again. Alright. It's like I always eat my words when I make walkthrough parts, because something happens that makes me just change my thoughts about the situation immediately. Okay. I think I'm going to use Mario's turn to heal up Goombella. You know, don't want to use the Life Shroom. And then... Oh wait, actually, should I just attack now? Nah, I'll do one more charge. Because she's got a lot of HP going on here. Good. Very good. Okay. Gotta concentrate. Give it everything I've got. Woo. And now, I think I will do... Oh, shoot. Well, I'm not doing it this turn, I guess. That's fine. Doesn't matter who I use the jelly on. Boop. Woo. Yeah, most of that most of that was used from charging. You know, the flower points that I was using. Alright. Power bounce. Let's get that damage multiplied. Oh, poopers. Yeah. Hopefully I can time this better. Come on. There we go. I stopped the pause for a second there because I wanted to really concentrate. And he's not too happy about the damage I'm doing to him. But yeah, I'm really nervous, even though I know I'm really close to victory, but that's what's making me extra nervous right now. I think I'm gonna use an Ultra Shroom on Mario just to be safe. As he cannot wipe out Mario in one shot. Okay, we're good. And I guess charged. It's working, right? Might as well keep at it. I think having two badges on Goombella to charge like that is a bit more cost effective than having just one badge, even though it uses two flower points instead of one. Alright, charge. I'm happy I got lucky there. Charge! Just charging and bouncing, that's my strategy for what people consider to be the hardest boss in the game. Can I finish it off with Mario? Nope, not quite. But I will be able to finish it off with Goombella, even if I totally miss on my multi-bonk. Yeah! My pet of 100 trials is over! Ding! Bye bye! I am so happy right now. Well, I'll be even happier if I know this recording was not glitched. Alright, let's get this. Return Postage Badge! Yep, that's the badge that you get. I mean, that's that surprise you get for making it all the way down to the final floor. And I'll give you a little tour of this room here. It looks like the other rooms with its wall detailing, except there's spikes along the bottom edges of the room here. But, oh boy, I really need a break right now. Not only that, but my Wii needs a break because I've been through two camera charges. I charged a camera before I made this part here, and the Wii's been on for like 7 or 8 hours, so I would really like to give it a rest here before I actually finish off this part. But I'm done. I actually made it. Yes. I've done it. And if you didn't know what I did, along the way here, I've also filled out both the badges as well as the catalog here. Look at this. No blank spots. No blank spots. Now watch there be a blank spot and my heart just sinks. My blood runs cold. Nah, it's okay. And badges, 85 out of 85. Yep. Completed. Done. Save. Save now. And I'll see you in just a sec when I rest myself the Wii and get everything prepared for the remainder of this part and the walkthrough. Alright, I am rested and raring to go for some more recording here. I'm also on the GameCube because of some reasons I'll get into when I get into them. But for now, I'm just going to head on back to Far Outpost to finish off that last trouble. I should say get the prize for the last trouble because, you know, we already know we finished it off. It's just a matter of going back over there. And we have a nice new way to get back there, actually. Now, what could that be? I kind of forgot. Oh, right. I have this badge. It's called the Bump Attack Badge, and it requires 5, but I gotta dump some stuff. Let's get rid of those, and because I'm not gonna be getting into battles with this. You'll see why in just a second here. So the Bump Attack Badge, if you touch something that is significantly weaker than you are, you will automatically defeat it out on the field. You don't have to battle it at all. This is the kind of thing that I've wanted for a long time, but, you know, since it's so deep in the pit of 100 trials, it's something that you typically get really, really late in the game. In my case, I got it at the very, very end of the game. In fact, this is like the post-game more than anything. Alright, now, we are here. What do you have to say about my victory? So, you erased my graffiti. Shapaf. Yep. You erased it, Shashoon. I am so grateful to you. But it is not like I can confirm whether or not you actually erased it or not. Shaboo. Oh well. I guess I'll just trust you. Shashakity! Take this reward. Shapow! Zess T, oh god, made it for me when I told her how much I was missing the snow. Shafoom. Woo! Actually, this item is pretty terrible. I'm going to start trying to fulfill my own wish now. But you cannot tell anyone what it is. Shafoom! Promise me. Shakroom! I promise that writing will never, ever see the light of day on the internet, ever. Run. Run away fast! Alright, now, the reason why I'm on the GameCube is because of the Happy Lucky Lottery thingajigger. You remember the Happy Lucky Lottery, right? Well, there's actually a little sort of kind of Easter egg of sorts, if you want to call it that, that kind of prevents cheaters. But it doesn't really work on the Wii, because it doesn't read the Wii's clock. It can only read the GameCube's clock, hence why I am, you know, playing on the GameCube here. But yeah, what I'm going to do is bump attack you. What I'm going to do is go and get a pick from the Happy Lucky Lottery, and then I'm going to save and reset the GameCube, and then we're gonna see what happens once I change the clock to a different date. Every day is a lucky day with Happy Lucky Lottery! Glad to see you again! What can I do for you? I want a number! One number per customer to cost 100 coins for a different number. Actually, no, hold on a sec. Actually, I just have to check the board. That's right. It's 4108. I am not even close. I forgot about that. That I just had to check the board, not go through him. Well, that's okay. And I get a mushroom. Alright, now what I'm gonna do is save, reset, and change the GameCube's clock.
Whoa. Look where we are. We're in the GameCube's menus. I don't think we've ever been here before.
Anyway, let's go to the calendar here and change the date to... I'm gonna stay like a couple days back just to make him extra suspicious. There we go. And oh no! I gotta close the GameCube disc cover! By the way, another way to get into there is if you don't close the cover, you can hold the A button on the GameCube controller and it should work just fine. And there we go! Paper Mario, the Thousand Year Door. And we're back over here. So let's see what the Happy Lucky Lottery. Uh-oh. Things aren't looking too good over here. So much for being the Happy Lucky Lottery. Something very unhappy has happened. You wouldn't happen to know what that is, would you? Maybe? Sorta? Let's see. Well, it's happened, and that's what matters. A very unhappy thing. There has been foul play in the Happy Lucky Lottery. The clock was tampered with! It makes me unhappy to have to ask about this at all, but I'm afraid I have to. So please, just answer me honestly. Did you tamper with the clock?
Nah, don't be ridiculous.
Happy Lucky Lottery is only happy and lucky because the players are happy and lucky. And they don't ever cheat. I mean, changing the clock? I can't even... You really didn't change the clock? Really?
No, it wasn't me.
I had to tell little Toadette that she couldn't play today, and she burst into tears. It just breaks my heart. Are you sure you didn't change the clock?
No way, man.
Really? You really didn't? Just tell me the truth and I'll forgive you. I swear I didn't. Okay, I understand. Let's just call this one a mistake, then. But I just don't know how it could have happened, Bomb. How lucky and unhappy to get it going again. Everyone will have to buy new numbers for 500 coins. Do you want a new number for 500 coins? Well, no, because I want to show a different bit of dialogue here. So hold on while I reset the GameCube again. But not the time this time, just the GameCube.
Whoa, we're back. That was quick.
Let's take a look-see over here. And yep, still ornery. So now this time I'm going to admit it to him. We're going to see different dialogue for this. Maybe sorta.
Yeah.
Yes, I did it. Oh, light of face. It's so angry. Oh, now it's sad. Oh my. The apocalypse. It's here. What? Well, I think we should be running now, Mario! Mario, get out of there! Just calm down! Calm down! No, it'll be okay, everything's okay! It's just one clock reset! Just one clock reset! Okay, what? No! We have to have the lottery!
I mean, if you ever do that again, I will end this game. I promise you'll never do it!
I might. This is so silly. Okay, let's do it for, you know, promise him that we won't this time. Alright, I will never do it again. I'll swear on all that is happy and lucky that you'll never do it again! I swear on all that stuff. Okay. Let it be for now then. But you really can never do that again! I want to start the game up again, but to get it going, everyone will have to buy new numbers at 500 coins each. Yeah, so you get the fine either way. Yeah, so I got a bunch from the Pit of 100 Trials, and the game's pretty much over anyway. Thanks for your business. Here's your new number. Woo! 8731's my number. Okay, by tomorrow, huh? Alright, I sure hope so. I sure hope nothing like that will ever happen again to... Oh wait, a notice. The Happy Lucky Lottery was for today has been suspended. See Lucky for more details. Just let's see. Should have the lottery system up and running again by tomorrow. I'm going to have heaven. La, 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 la. Yeah, okay. So, I really hope that never happens again. Don't you? Actually, no, I do hope that happens again. So, I decided to change the date again. And, well, let's see what's going on at the Happy Lucky Lottery here. And, hey, how's it going? To get the lottery going again, everyone must... What? I thought I bought enough... Huh? What? It's not... doing the thing that's supposed to do the thing, Yeah, something else is supposed to happen. He's actually supposed to game over you if you reset the clock again. What? I don't understand, and I'm sure I reset the clock again. So, Maybe it's supposed to be done. I was gonna say maybe it's supposed to be done on another day, but since it's reading the GameCube clock no matter what, if I reset the clock no matter what, it's gonna get ornery again, so... let's try it one more time. What I mean is that it shouldn't matter how I reset the clock, because resetting the clock is resetting the clock regardless if a day has passed since the last event happened anyway. So I'm kinda puzzled by this, but let's try this again here and see... No, still not doing it, huh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this guy is supposed to be able to game over you if you... tamper with the clock again. I don't know. maybe I was misinformed or something, but... Well, in any case, I have one thing left to do, and I am going to go over to it right now. Ah, we're here. At the great tree. Why are we here? Well... because there's something that I've wanted to do here since very early in the walkthrough. And I think you know what's gonna happen now. Hello there, little guy. How about a belly rub? Yes! I have fulfilled my dream of rubbing a puny's belly! And with that, the walkthrough is now concluded. Well, maybe not quite. I mean, I do have the Zess T recipe list to do, but I'm talking about main gameplay parts. I'll do the Zess T recipe list in a separate video, which I'll just slap over the next button, which I grayed out. And with that, I'm gonna end off the walkthrough here. I hope you enjoy, and... I'll see you in the next walkthrough. Yeah, that's a good boy. It's a good boy. Ooh, so good. It's so cute and lovable and furry and fluffy.